Hey, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you a tool called autopep8. And it's a package that you need to download if you want to use it. And it will automatically format your Python code to conform to the pep8 style guide. So this is a guide that we talked about earlier in the course, but it just explains some conventions you should follow. You know, for when you're using comments, for example, don't use extra indentation. Or if we scroll down, what else do we have? You know, tabs versus spaces, maximum length of lines, when you should wrap it over onto the next line. There's a lot of stuff that is kind of, well, it's pretty specific compared to some other style guides for languages. And you don't have to do this yourself. You can use autopep8. Back on the documentation, all we need to do is start by installing. I already have it, but it's python3-m pip install autopep8, number 8. And it tells me requirement already satisfied. Okay, so I already have it, and I have a file that we're going to use it on. So this file is messy, and it has a bunch of problems in it. For example, this is a long comment. It should be wrapped to fit within 72 characters, according to the pep8 style guide. I'm not gonna count 72 characters personally. Here I have, you know, extra space in this tuple. What else is going on? You know, a long string. There's a couple of other things, you know, a very long dictionary. You get it. We're gonna just work on indenting things properly and formatting it nicely, and you'll see what a difference autopep8 makes. The syntax can be quite complex if you wanna use all of the options. I'll just point out some of the more important ones. So when we run it, we're gonna call autopep8 from the command line, and I usually run it in place. So you can tell it to run in place, where do they explain that? Here we go. Using -i or --- in place, make changes to the file in place. I usually have no reason to keep the first version, that's all ugly. I just want the nice, prettified version. So that's one option I pass in. You also can pass in an option called aggressive or -a as a flag. And what this will do, most of the changes that autopep8 makes relate to white space. Adding lines in if your strings are getting too long or your dictionaries are getting too long, figuring out how to format things nicely, removing trailing spaces, all that stuff. But there are certain things that if you tell it to be more aggressive, it will change. For example, in the style guide, it tells you if you're checking if a variable is true or false, you don't use is, and you're not supposed to use double equals either. Instead, you should just say if greeting, or if not greeting, or something like that, instead of using is or double equals. And if you have this in your code and you use autopep8 without aggressive, it won't change this. It will just fix white space problems like we've already talked about. But if you do tell it to be aggressive, it will fix this, and it will change it to this. Anyway, so as far as usage, we're gonna start with autopep8-- in place, and then the file name. So in my terminal, I'll paste that, and then the file name, oh, I already forgot. I called it uglycode.py, and you just run this on whatever file you want, make sure you're in the same directory. Takes a moment, doesn't look like anything happened, but if I go back to my file, hopefully you saw that change. No code has been changed other than white space being added or removed. Most of it was being added in our case to make it's a lot nicer to look at. You know, very clear what's happening now. And I'm gonna add a little bit of extra code here just to show something. If I have a value like cat, let's say is cat owner is true, and then I wanna add a statement like if is cat owner, and I'll start with saying double equals, let's say true. If that's the case, then I'm going to print meow. Okay, so see what it looks like before. And if I go back and run it, but this time I add in, well, if I just run it on its own again, you'll see it didn't change that because it's only doing white space changes. But if I run it now with -a, I don't want to type -aggressive. -a tells it to be aggressive, and I think that only did one level of aggressiveness. I think we have to do two separate -a's to tell it to be doubly aggressive, which, there we go, you can see it now changed. If is cat owner, print meow. So I just wanted to show you that there are different levels. I'm not entirely clear at what happens at each particular level, but if you just want formatting of the white space, you don't need to use -a or -aggressive at all. If you do want it to take care of things like this, then you can use two -a's in this example. But the big point I wanted to make here is that external modules like this, external packages, can really help us out. Nobody wants to sit here and do this on their own and memorize all these rules even, because if you're switching between programming languages, it differs. And there's a lot to keep track of just as far as the syntax itself, let alone the style guides and conventions. So it's much easier, in my opinion at least, to use something like autopep8. And as a final note, there is a Sublime text package, if you are using Sublime, that you can install that will do this for you in Sublime, so you don't even have to, you know, run it from the command line. There's just a command you run in Sublime that will do it. I'm not going to go through the installation process because in one of my other courses, I did show something similar, in a Sublime package. It wasn't for Python. And I don't think I've ever had more problems or more questions about something. It just worked very differently on everybody's machine, between Macs and PCs and different versions of software, you know, OS, whatever, versus Sierra. Anyway, it was just a nightmare. So I'm not going to go through and cement it in my video and never be able to change it. I highly recommend it. If you do use Sublime all the time, go to this GitHub repo and you can follow the instructions. Anyway, that's autopep8.